Fusion and DaVinci Resolve is way deeper than most people realize. Reactor alone has hundreds of powerful tools, but barely anyone talks about them. So in this series, I'm breaking it all down, one effect at a time.
In today's Fusion breakdown, we're going to be going over the Reflect node from the Chinese Reactor forums. So I'm going to get the CGS Reflect. And this is the original node that you'll get from the forums. It's all in Chinese, so I went through the hassle of translating everything to English. You're more than welcome to download this from the description. First, I'm going to get my media. So let me get a background, something to reflect in the foreground. Okay, I'm feeling kind of good today. So I'm going to add a quick little gradient like that. All right, now I have a nice faded background. So the Reflect node is pretty easy to use and pretty simple. It's a macro that adds reflections to your media, and it takes the alpha channel and crop. You may have this issue where your media is too small or too big and it gets cut off. You can fix that easily by adding in a background node and then pressing Control T on the merge, and that can give you more space. I think I actually have to make my stuff smaller. So let's break down how this node works. First, you have reflection mode, and you have a choice from flat to perspective. Switching it to perspective will enable the skew slider, and you can make slight micro adjustments to the perspective. Then you have flat, which will keep it in place like this. The skew slider will not work. You have position, which will change the position of the reflection and the media. Reflection distance, it'll make a nice fall off. And then reflection fall off will control the softness of that fall off. Then blur type, there's two blur types, the directional blur and then the soften blur. And the soften blur, I believe, is coming from the very blur node. So blur offset changes how blurry the image is. Blur amount changes the overall amount of blur. And blur fall off masks the blur the same way the reflection fall off does. And blend changes the opacity of the whole reflection. And reflection only just puts in the reflection. So let's say I wanted to composite the reflection itself and maybe add some displacement maps to it or some color. What I would have to do is press reflection only, merge, branch this out. And now that the reflection itself is branched out, that allows me to have full control of the reflection. So let's say I want to change the color of it, or maybe I want to add some scan lines. As you can see, this is a very useful node, and it allows for quick compositing of 2D reflections. So I highly recommend using this on your composites and your edits in the future. Anyway, that's it for today's video. Subscribe for more.